I mean, it started in Belgium and spread throughout Europe, and then about 20 years ago, over 20 years ago, and then it came to North America, the States, about 10 years ago, and it's been spread across Canada, specifically with the support of Tennis Canada and their community development team, and they've been doing that for over 5 years now. Describe that traditionally in tennis lessons, kids, before the age of 10 were rarely able to play with the real ball on the full court because it's too fast, it's too hard, rackets were too heavy. So they took tennis lessons where they stood in lines and they learned how to hit strokes, but they didn't actually derive the enjoyment that we all do, tennis players, from actually playing the game. So it was really hard to get kids motivated. Well, if you look at other sports like hockey and soccer, and they're getting kids in very young, 5, 6, 7, playing the game, and progressive tennis allows kids now to play at a very young age. It's in terms of learning, obviously now kids, because they can play the game, they can learn tactics, they can learn how to hit the ball, they can learn about what it takes to keep the ball in play and to position yourself on a court. Basic fundamentals of the game that they wouldn't have been able to learn in a non-game-based setting. The development of progressive tennis equipment. And so basically, instead of using the large net, the real net, nets are sold and can be purchased in 18 feet long nets. So the nets are smaller, they're lower, rackets are now smaller and lighter than they used to be, which is really important for kids. And there's a system of balls that are introduced for kids, depending on what age and what level they're at. There's a total of 5 different balls, starting from a foam ball to a larger red ball, which is low compression, and then medium compression with the orange ball, and then almost full compression with the green dot ball, and then finally the green ball. And that's really important. I would say that's the most important part of allowing kids to ease into the game, because the real ball is very hard, very fast, very bouncy, and for a kid that's less than 3 feet tall, that ball is going to be bouncing over their head every single time. So, Wilson and the other tennis companies developed a system where balls would bounce on average in the same proportion to their height as a real ball would bounce to the height of an average adult. So that part is very important about progressive tennis. So Tennis Canada has one of their 4 main goals, what's the word? Directives or initiatives, is community tennis development. So they have a program called Building Tennis Communities, which is designed to promote tennis and develop capacity in terms of facilities and just the basic things that a community needs in order to start a tennis program or to develop, to build a court or something like that. So it's looking at more rural areas, underserved areas in Canada. Like, their Tennis Canada's main goal is to grow the game. However, as we know, tennis is a great game for promoting health, active living. Also, the skills that are required to play tennis are very diverse. Like, you need good movement skills, coordination, intelligence, in terms of, building a point and being tactical. And it's also it's a sport for life, which is really important. Tennis Canada has another community development program designed for major markets, and it's called the Little Aces program. And basically, what it is, it's a strategy to grow tennis in kids 12 and under in major markets. So there's a Little Aces program that's just been started in Ottawa, and I'm coordinating. We've started 13 progressive tennis programs now just this year alone, in 2014 as well, with City of Ottawa Parks and Rec. So we can use gymnasiums, rec center gyms, It's also great that we can get it into schools now. You can set up progressive tennis nets in a school gymnasium, and with three nets and three courts, run a really fun, high energy and active tennis phys ed class for 24 kids in a typical primary school gym. As well, we're trying to partner with some of the more expensive private clubs to offer a bit of court space on weekends to develop team-based leagues. Tennis Canada has recognized that playing, well, any sport, but specifically tennis, is really, it's more fun, the most fun, when kids get to compete against their friends and against their family in teams. So we're going to try and start a few pilot team-based leagues at the more expensive centers at a reduced cost, so that kids essentially from anywhere have the ability to participate in the program. And it's also a sport that requires less organization. Like, you don't need to join a team and be in a league. There are many varieties of competition or just recreational play that a player can participate in, and they can play on a public court. It's not only is it a great sport for that reason, but it's also accessible. All you need are a few balls and a tennis racket, and you can head out onto a public court and play with a friend or family at very low cost. So that's really important as well. St. James has been running a progressive tennis program for the last 3 years, and we run an after-school program where we bring kids aged as young as 5 years old all the way up to, well, we do teenagers, so 5 to 17 years old. And kids 5 to 9, they learn, or 5 to 10, they learn progressive tennis, or learn tennis in a progressive way with the modified equipment. And the program has been very successful. We've had a great response from the community. Kids really love it, and what they love is the actual game of tennis. We find that as coaches, it's very easy now to teach a kid how to play tennis, because you put them in the environment, you teach them the rules and how to play the game, and they start playing, and as a coach you can help them improve their technique and their tactics and positioning through various exercises. But just having kids that are that enthusiastic about the game really, really kind of shows all of us that that we're doing something right here. It's fun. It's fun, but it's challenging. Like I said, you require so many different skills to be successful in tennis, and it really makes you think on court. I personally like it because it's an individual sport, and it really challenges me to sometimes to find inner strength where I didn't know I had some. But no, it really is a great sport. My name is John Winspurdy, and I'm the tennis director here at St. James Tennis Club, and I'm also the regional coordinator for the OTA in Ottawa and the Little Aces coordinator in Ottawa.